Is this? Oh, what? I'm live. This is so weird. Yeah. I was unsure whether to private this or not or make it unlisted, but I was like, you know what? Forget it. I'm listening to music actually. I should probably turn this off. Turn off YouTube. I'm using my phone as well. So I don't know if this would work or not. I know no one's gonna watch this live because everyone has stuff to do, but I'm thinking of sorting out all my coins, and I thought I'm too lazy to record or make a video and edit and then upload. So I was just like, I'm just gonna do this. Hopefully it'll work. If not, I'm just gonna delete it. As you can see, I'm actually in my living room, and everyone's out of the house, so I'm home by myself. Sorry if my hair looks super weird, because I just washed it, and usually I part it to the side. Dude, it looks funny. So usually I look like that, but yeah. But I use a headband to get my hair out of the way, so I look like that. But I have a coin collection. Let me move you back. This is a glass table, so it's probably gonna get dirty or something. But I have a piggy bank. Oh, bad connection. Let me move you forward. Okay. And I had this since I was probably 10 or maybe even 12. So I've been collecting coins since then. And I was just trying to get all the states that are on the coins. So North Dakota, South Dakota, and I actually even have like post-its to say how much money I have. This was 2 years ago. I had $20 worth of coins. And I took that to TD Bank because they do take coins and then give you cash as a return. But now I'm just like, this is taking up space. And I know I don't have all my coins for the collection. So I'm just gonna, you know, get rid of it, sadly. And I don't know if TD still does it, but I heard that they got rid of the machine that you put the coins in. Instead, you have to put it in these, which my brother had. So they're just like, you know, those paper cases of coins. So I'm actually, I was thinking of what I would do while I'm just sorting out my coins, because I know people would think it's boring or whatever. And I was just like, let me do a Q&A. Even though no one is asking me questions, I'm gonna look up questions and answer them. So I searched up icebreaker questions. Oh, this looks good. Funny icebreaker questions to get to know someone. And I thought maybe it would be interesting. Okay. So I even have like Canadian coins or special coins, actual special coins rather than just generic state coins. I mean, they did start doing a new thing with a different design on the coin. You can't see it, but it has that rim of circle around it. I don't know. I might keep those. I'm just gonna get rid of the generic ones with the states. So yeah, special coins. I was thinking of just doing this on the floor, but then it might look funny. Because the table itself, I have to like hunch over. And it's pretty short, it's a coffee table, so. What do I do? See, this is what I want to do on the floor, so I can sit. You know what? Forget it. I'm sitting on the floor. Oh, what? Okay, well. First question, I have it like right here. What is your earliest memory? I know a lot of people ask me before, but I think my earliest one that I can remember is probably in not even pre-K. I was in daycare. And my, no, not, okay, I don't know where I'm going with this, but, oh, who is that? I already got into college, and I am going to, I probably shouldn't say it, because I'm scared that they're stalkers, but I'm going to college in the fall, so yeah, don't worry about that. But it's not out of state, I'm not moving. Or anything, so I'm gonna be staying in New York. That's funny. There's only one person in the room. Hi! I don't know your name, but let me see. Okay. Show. Tribeth? I don't know how to say it. I'm sorry. Nice curvy profile picture. Anyways. Hi! Do I know you? No, you probably. Okay, that's kind of cool. Because most people that I know that watch my videos are either my classmates that found my YouTube or my cousins who are too young to be on YouTube, to be honest. I'm sorting my coins. Oh, I can move you because you're on my phone. So yeah, my coins. Nope. That's okay, why did I do that? Anyways. My earliest memory, going back on track, I remember, this is like the best memory I have when I was really young, and kind of my earliest. I was probably 5 or so, and whenever my mom was like doing chores or something, and she wanted me and my brother to get out of her way, so she would be like mopping or something, and she would tell us to go away, and to reward us, she would make us hide so she could get out her candy and we wouldn't know where she hides it. And she would give us these lemon candies. And that's kind of like my earliest memory. What did you enjoy about school? I can go in order actually. So I'll do elementary, middle, junior high school, and then now high school. So elementary school, my best memory was second grade, and we had a really cool teacher, and she would let us have free time, and when we had free time, she would put on music, and I really distinctly remember that she plays Mamma Mia. So we would all dance to freeze dance, and we would freeze whenever the song stops to Mamma Mia. So yeah. Middle school. It was fourth grade, and we had after school Chinese class, so it was 3 to 5 o'clock. And while my teacher was like teaching and stuff, she was pretty chill. She wasn't that strict. So it was like a class of 20 of us, even like maybe less, 15 or so. So it was pretty small. And she would be doing her thing, teaching. And me and my friends would be on the floor, crawling, playing games. And she wouldn't really care. So yeah. That's middle school memory. What I enjoyed most about junior high school was probably my friends. We were kind of rebels in 7th and 8th grade. Like, yeah. We got into some trouble, but not too much trouble. And in high school, it was just the friends I made. Everyone was really cool. I'm trying to sort my coins into states, but I think that might be too much work. Because there's a lot of coins that, yeah. There's a lot of quarters. Okay, next question. Name one thing you miss being... What the... Name one thing you miss about being a kid. I would say just not caring what's happening in the future, because honestly, now, that's all I'm thinking about. I'm scared for my life, guys. They're like, well, what do you want to do with your life? I honestly don't know. Honestly don't know. Who was your enemy or bully when you were young? My brother. Always. If you have siblings, you kind of know what I mean. Unless you're like the rare ones that actually get along with your siblings, then props to you. But for me, it was my brother. But if it's not talking about, like, natural enemies, if you were to say. Because, yeah. Honestly, I was never a cool kid. Like, I was probably the average people that existed in school. And was just there. And was never that special in a way. So I think my enemies would be probably the popular kids, because I was like, oh my god, look at them. They're all cool and stuff. It wasn't like I wanted to be them, but it was more like, ew, they're cool and I'm not. But that's okay, because being cool is so gross. okay. What was your favorite musical group when you were in junior high? Musical group? I think they're just talking about like artists in general. It was probably like Big Time Rush. I was such a huge Disney fan, so it was mostly like Nickelodeon, Big Time Rush, but Nickelodeon and Disney stars that I like was obsessed with. So anyone that was singing on those shows are probably it. Yeah. When you were a kid, what did you want to be when you grew up? I wanted to be a waiter and a cashier, because those are what my parents were, and I thought that was really cool. And I was like, oh my god, look at them. And then I wanted to be a chef, because my parents were always cooking. So, a chef. Yeah. When was the first time you had a beer? I don't know. I mean, my parents drink wine at home. So when I was younger, I was probably like 12 or something when they let me have a sip. But I don't, because my parents don't drink beer, they drink wine. Worst roommate you ever had? I live with my brother. I share a room with him, so he's the one and only roommate I've ever had, and he was the worst one too. What is your worst dating experience? What kind of icebreaker question is that? I've never dated. Haven't dated. I don't think I will in this coming time. Even though I'm 17, going to 18. Never dated. Which is the most funniest prank played on you or played by you? I don't do a lot of pranks and not a lot of my friends prank me. But this is one time, it was last year. My friend called me on her birthday and I didn't know who it was, because whenever I picked it up, it would be like silent and then I would hang up, because I was like, that's really weird. But this person called me. Hi. Hi, descendant from the sky. So anyways, talking about pranks. My friend, she called me on my birthday, and I didn't know who it was. And she called me 3 times in a row, and I was like, this is really freaky. Okay, let me just answer this phone call and not say anything, because I want to hear what they have to say. And then it was like Adele was playing on the phone. I was like, that's kind of weird. Why is this person calling me and playing Adele? And then a few seconds later, I hear a certain song that me and her had as an inside joke, and I knew it was her. So after that, I messaged her, and she was like, oh, that's really funny. Why did you keep hanging up on me? And I was like, yeah. There's only like one person here watching. Okay, whatever. Okay, this is like... Okay, so those are icebreaker questions from the past, and this is just asking about facts now. Where is your most favorite place on this earth? I would say, even though I've never been there, I would say probably anywhere that is nature related. So I really want to go to Alaska or Northern Canada, or even like in a place that has a forest. And my friends know that because they always make fun of me, like, oh my god, Vicky, you're going to be in a forest in the future and in your little cabin and stuff like that. So that's kind of where I want to go. Either Alaska, Northern Canada, Iceland, or Greenland. Those are like the top places I want to go. Yeah. Why do you like living in this area? I live in New York City. I'm 17. I didn't get to choose where I live. I was born here. But what I do like most about living in this area is just the people, the diversity. That's what makes New York, New York. So yeah. Oh, I have what? I have a European coin. It has a little Bermuda Elizabeth II. Is this it? Don't know. What do you consider the most important event of your life so far? I would say the most important or the most life-changing was probably my high school years, because that's when I realized certain stuff about myself and how I should change for the better and for myself and not other people. Do you feel you have a purpose or a calling in life? Not really. I don't have a calling, I don't think, but I do think that I want to do something with my life, like everyone else. What am I saying? But I do want to tell stories and share my voice. That's why I wanted to be a filmmaker, or I'm trying to be right now. I'm studying film in college, so hopefully that comes true. Do you have any phobias? No, but I do have fears. I have a fear of heights, and I remember I was watching a video and they were talking about the fear of holes. And I was like, who has a fear of holes? There's holes in everything. But then I googled it, and I was like, oh my god, that's so creepy. That freaks me out.
So whatever you do, don't search that up. I promise you it's nothing that you'll like. Okay, now these are philosophy icebreaker questions. Oh, I made this up before, and I asked people this, but if your house was on fire, and you could grab only three things before leaving, what would they be? I would say my journals. I could make that one thing, my journal, because I've started writing since I was probably 9 or something like that, or probably 10 years old, and I think those are the things that I'd love to look back on, and I don't think I could miss if it was burned up by a fire. Second, my Hello Kitty toy. That sounds weird, but I've had this Hello Kitty plushie since I was probably like 9. And my parents got it for me, and I still love it today, and I still have it today. And I love it. I don't think I could live without it. Not that serious, but it's just like, I would be really sad if I didn't have it. What else? The third thing. My Calvin and Hobbes series. I have all the books in the whole comic book series, and I'd be really disappointed if I didn't have them anymore. Not disappointed, but sad. Okay, next question. Do you believe in ghosts? Yes. That's a pretty simple answer. Yes, I do. I just think that there's so many things in life that I don't know about that it's not possible for ghosts not to exist. Not that I want to see anything anytime soon, but I do believe that. Ghosts and spirits, yes. Okay, this is what I have so far. Can you see this? That's my knee, sorry. I'm trying to sort out all of them. I didn't do it by state yet, but that's kind of, yeah, that's what I have so far. Do you believe in extraterrestrial or life on other planets? Duh! We live in one galaxy out of the probably millions. So how is it possible for people to think that it's just us? So yeah, I do believe that we are not the only ones. What the hell is this question? If you were one of two people left on this earth, and the other one was the same sex as you, would you go gay? What? That's so stupid. First of all, how can you repopulate the world even if you're the same sex and even if you go gay? Just dumb. What kind of question is this? If you had to change your name, what would you change it to? I like the name Jamie, but I don't think I would fit it, maybe. Maybe that? What crazy activities do you dream of trying someday? I like to go backpacking or something. Or just exploring in general. That would be cool. You get to travel and just see things for your own self. Rather than look at it through pictures or movies, anything like that. If you could go on a road trip with any person, dead or alive, who would you choose and where would you go? don't know. Like, I can't see any of my friends backpacking with me because, yeah. Can I? Like, definitely not my best friends because they have, like, stuff they want to do themselves and they're not the hiking kind of person or traveling kind of person. But I don't know. Oh! I thought of one person, but they're a celebrity. And it's more of like a fantasy thing. You know when you have celebrity crushes and you just think of everything you could do together? That's what I'm thinking about right now. But no. No one I would go road tripping with. Because honestly, if I were to go road tripping, I'd rather go alone. Because it's like a spiritual thing of just being yourself and connecting with the world around you by yourself. So maybe I'll go alone. What do you think the secret to a good life is? As cheesy as it sounds, just doing what you love and loving what you do. Honestly, that's what I want to do right now. But, yeah. I heard something really funny this week. It was a film, and it was talking about the value of money. And the quote, or what they were trying to say is, if you think that money can't buy you happiness, then you're spending your money wrong. And I was like, that's kind of true, because you can do a lot of things with your money, and people who think like, oh, you can't buy happiness with money, I mean, it is kind of true. It depends on what you're buying or what you're using that money for. So yeah, doing your dream job. It's already been 30 minutes. What the hell? Sorry. Was there ever a time when you were frightened for your life? Many times. More times than I wished happened. But one was when I was younger. Okay. Favorite movie and why, Vicky? It's hard to choose, but I think one of my favorite movies is what's it called? Dead Poets Society. And I think just any coming of age movie is like a deal with me because I love just stories about people realizing themselves or finding themselves because I don't know. Kind of gives you a little hope of, or insight on how someone can do that, or how I can do that. Yeah. I don't know, I cry easily at movies, honestly, so it's hard to say. You should watch Sing Street. What's that about? Nope. Okay. Watch and find out. True. Okay. Do you have any other question? I'm basically just having a conversation with one person. Should I move on to another question that I have right here? Any deep questions or just questions you want to ask me? That. Oh. Who's your go-to Mario Kart character? Honest? Really? Luigi. Always Luigi. I have a friend who always chooses Toad. I'm like, what the hell? He's the slowest person. Why would you choose Toad? Yeah. It used to be Yoshi, but now it's Luigi. What is this? Hong Kong coin? Wow. Someone said, same, lol, Toad is my fave. Toad is slow. Why would you choose him? I was watching Friends before. Oh, he's cute. Let me put on Friends.
Of extremism. These issues, if they were to be put into one basket.
Does anyone have, like, shows they can suggest? I just finished watching Baby Daddy, and I'm kind of, like, sad that it ended. So now I have, like, nothing to watch. I'll put Friends in the background. Rick and Morty. Okay. I think I heard of that one. Because I usually go for, like, funny shows. Game of Thrones, really? Of course you would say Game of Thrones. I'm almost done. Like, there's still... Okay. I don't answer one of these questions. What was I talking about before? Okay, this one is cool. What is one thing for you... Wait, what? What is one thing for which you would most like to be remembered after your death? Very existential question, but honestly, one thing I would like to happen for me, and as morbid as it sounds, but like one of the reasons I've written journals is because I like to think that I would become a writer at one point, or just write one book. Sorry. I would write a book in the future, and then hopefully I'd publish all my journals as a collection in the future so people could read it. So when I'm dead, people would still be able to read my thoughts and my memories as a 9-year-old. You know what that makes? Does that make sense? So they'd be able to read my history from 9 years old to probably like now. And it's just like they see all my thoughts, my feelings, and the things that's been going on in my life. So it's kind of like a memoir, but everything's written by myself. So yeah, it's like a scrapbook of my life that's in a book for everyone to read. So that's kind of one thing I want people to remember me about. Keep saying I have bad connection. Okay. Oh. This is kind of a similar question that I asked my friends. If you knew you were gonna die in 24 hours, name 3 things you would like to do in the time you had left. I used to tell people that I would write letters if I were to die in 24 hours. Honestly, I don't think I would do anything that big. Like, I wouldn't, like, go bungee jumping in the last day that I was living or anything like that. I honestly would want to continue living life the way I am. So I would just like still stay on the couch watching TV and just let death come to me like that. I would want to like talk to some of my friends before, but I wouldn't like warn them. I would be like, oh my god, I'm dying. Look at me, like, come visit me. I'm gonna die in the next 2 hours. Honestly, it's kind of like death is meant to be a surprise. Not a surprise, that sounds weird, but it's supposed to come naturally. And if you tell people that you're gonna die, it's kind of like, you know what I mean? Maybe you do, maybe you don't, but I wouldn't do anything different. So that question kind of defeats its purpose. But what crazy activities do you dream of trying someday? Did I answer this already? I think I did. I was talking about backpacking. Yeah, I don't know. Answer. Whatever. What do you value most in life? Friends. Because those are the people that will be there when everything goes to the trash can. And I think those are the people that will lift you up when you're at your lowest point. So you can have as many friends as you can or want, but who really is gonna be at your side when you're broke, when you're in trouble, when you need help? Those are the people that count the most. So I think friends. And just the people in general that you surround yourself with. Because you only have a certain amount of time in your life. And even if there's annoying people, you just want to make the most out of it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm just rewatching Friends episodes because I've watched the season over like 5 times. And this is the episode where Joey is interviewed by the soap opera digest. Soap opera digest person for the magazine. What the hell? This question says, what was your favorite childhood injury? What? How can you have a favorite injury? That sounds so messed up. Honestly, I got hurt a lot when I was younger. I have like a bunch of scars on my leg from just falling down in general. But why would you have a favorite child injury? It's kind of an interesting question. I don't think I can answer that because I don't have a favorite injury. But if it's not talking about like being physically hurt, I would say it's not my favorite, but it's the most memorable. Is like, this is gonna sound so funny and cheesy, but when I was in middle school, I had like a few crushes here and there. And I guess having realized that I have to get over my crush because it's just not gonna happen, so that's kind of like a injury. You can ask me about, oh, of course, who was your high school crush? I don't have one, okay? Like, there's good looking people in my high school, but not enough to be a crush. Like, once they open their mouth, I'm just like, yeah, That's one of the reasons why I don't like you. Okay, I'm reading the chat right now. It says, I recall you telling me that you would say... I would say what? Look. It's too funny. Look. Wait. Joey was wearing a thong. If you were to choose the top three, like good looking people, top three good looking people in my high school. Would, cause I'm afraid that people will find us and they'll be like, oh my god, that's me. It's kind of cringy. Okay. The thing is, like, the people who are good looking in my high school is that they know that they're good looking. So they're just like, ah. Like that. Especially for the guys. Like, they know they're good looking, so they kind of flaunt it. And that just makes them less attractive, in my opinion, for their personality. Yeah, I don't want to say their names, because it's kind of, like, dangerous if you were to say it, but there's this one... It's so weird to talk about it. Okay, I'm just going to say their names, because... I'm never gonna see them again. So, there is Peter. Cause yeah, everyone knows he's a good looking guy. Peter, Tashi. Who else? There's not actually a lot of good looking guys in our school. Peter, Tashi, Tenzing. Yeah, those are good looking guys. And there's like a few more, but you said top three, so I'm just gonna say top three. And those are like the most obvious. There's like some underrated good looking people too. Which sucks. There's just one girl though. She's so annoying. Her name is Sofa, and I'm like, what are you doing talking to me? Yeah, she's just annoying. I'm so glad I'm not her friend anymore. Just kidding. What are you doing at home anyways? I thought you were gonna be out. Sorry, I'm talking to the chat. I feel like people who are gonna watch this back are gonna be like, what is Vicky doing with her life? And I would be like, I don't know either, because I'm just sitting here, a loner, sorting out my coins. Playing Mario Kart. If we were to talk about crushes. Ooh, interesting. I was actually gonna do like a series talking about all my crushes. And even like the little ones in middle school and high school. But I guess I can talk about it a little bit now. But there has been a few good looking people that have caught my eye. It has got me like, so yeah, I just usually keep them as eye candy. Do you collect only American coins? No, I don't. I have some when I was traveling, but most of them are American because I'm in America. I have, oh, that's a dollar coin. I have a coin from Hong Kong. This is not even a coin. This is like a token for an arcade. Hong Kong coins. I went to China like 4 years ago. I have... What is this? Oh, what? Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. I think I'm saying that right. But yeah, that one. I have a coin from Mexico. Some of them are given to me from friends or family when they've been traveling. And some are actually my own. I have a European coin. But yeah, those are the ones I have right now. But yeah. Let me show you. Here. Those are all the things I have. Planet Sim says, I collect coins and money too, but it's way easier as an European because I have... Ah, no, it went away. Because it's easier as an European because I have to travel less distance for different coins. Oh, yeah, that makes sense. How bad can your feet stink? What the hell? I just took a shower, so my feet doesn't stink, okay? But yeah, that must be cool to live in Europe. Because, yeah, you don't have to travel a lot. Message retracted. Funny. Okay. Friends. What episode is this? I think it's the one with the baby shower. Alright. Do you guys have any more questions? I could go to a different webpage to find different questions. Fun icebreaker questions for meetings. Okay, maybe that one. If you were a vegetable, what vegetable would you be? What? I think I would be a bell pepper. Because I like bell peppers. Yeah. And they're colorful too. If you woke up tomorrow as an animal, what animal would you choose to be and why? I would be a goldfish. Because they live it. Oh, I know. They can't sleep. I would probably be a dog, like, honestly. Because it's like being a human, except you don't have that responsibility of being a human. What favorite color are you? And how does being that color make you feel? I'm blue. Because I'm, like, calm. In blue most of the time. If you could sit on a bench in a beautiful woods, who would you like sitting next to you on the bench and why? John O. Callaghan. Because he's from my favorite band. And I think just having a conversation with him would be cool. And I like to like pick his brain at certain sessions. Or just get to know him in general. Yeah. Because honestly, like, if you were to meet your favorite person, or celebrity, or singer, or whatever, you would most likely want to, you know, be their friends or something. And that'd be cool. So yeah. Are you sunrise, daylight, twilight, or night? Please share why you picked your time of day. I would be night, because I'm a night owl, and I get things done at night, honestly. And I think there's something just really calming about, like, if you were in the woods or something, seeing the stars and just hearing nothing but the trees rustling, branches rustling, and stuff like that. It's just really calming. If you could choose your age forever, what age would you choose and why? I used to tell my friends that I wish I was 70 right now, because when you're at that age, you don't have to do anything. Like, you can retire and basically live life normally without any responsibility. So you could just eat, sleep, and watch TV for the rest of your days and not care that much. But honestly, I'd probably want to be probably in my like late 20s, early 30s, because at that point you kind of know where your life is on track, kind of, and you're still young to do things, but then you're not too young where you're restricted and looked down on. What item that you don't have already would you most like to own? I was actually thinking of buying a typewriter because I think they're cool and it would be just nice to be able to feel while you're typing and seeing it in front of you physically at that very second in that moment. And it's kind of the idea that you're the only person in this world that is writing or typing on this very same typewriter at this very moment with your own words. And it's just you and yourself in that typewriter. So I wanted to get a typewriter. But they're expensive. Very expensive. They're like 100 to 500 even. And I'm just like, the thing is, I mostly find them on Etsy, and they're usually sold before I get the chance to even look at it. Are you spring, summer, fall, or winter? Please share why. I am winter. It's probably most likely because I'm a winter baby. I was born in December, so it's kind of, maybe that's why, but again, it's very calm. There's not chaos like in the summer, and I don't get allergies in the spring. And spring is kind of like, I don't know. It's not very nice, I don't think. People always think like, oh, the sun is shining, the flowers are blooming. But honestly, in the spring in New York, it's like all slush and like dead branches or whatever that fell during the winter, and it's just like all icky, and then you never know how the weather is like, so don't like the spring. Summer's too hot. I actually like fall, but sometimes it rains too much and it's just like wet leaves everywhere and it's kind of like annoying. So winter, because I love the snow as well. I'm probably gonna go soon. I mean, I have all my coins sorted. So yeah, I still haven't done it by state. But I'm probably gonna do that now. I'll answer one more question from this list, or if any of you guys have any. I don't think they have any more good questions. If you were a city, which city would you choose to be and why? I would naturally say New York. But If I'm gonna choose different city, I would say I actually don't know a lot of places. Okay, never mind. I won't answer that one. If you could be in the movie of your choice, what movie would you choose and what character would you play? That's interesting. I honestly, I watch more narratives, so that's like scripted work and like probably the blockbuster movies you see, than other movies or movie genres. Okay, let's actually do movie or TV show. And I would choose Friends, ironically, not because I'm watching it right now, but because I love Friends. Like, it's my favorite, one of my favorite TV shows. If I were to choose a character, I want to say I'm more like probably Ross or Chandler. But realistically, who I'm more related to is Monica. Because there's just some OCD things that I always do. Or I just like doing things in a certain particular way. And Monica is like that too. But personality-wise, I'm probably like Chandler. Because I always do like stupid things and I say ironic stuff that I don't know. There's just moments where I'm like chilling. So yeah. Besides Friends, if I were to choose another one, it would be Big Bang Theory. Because I love the Big Bang Theory, and I am probably like Leonard or something. Yeah, I'll be Leonard. Because I'm like that awkward person that he is too. But not awkward enough to be Sheldon. Not creepy enough to be Howard, but I am probably emotionally broken, like Cuthbert Polly. He's too funny. Anyways, I'm gonna go, guys. I'm gonna sort my coins and finally put them in these little paper things. Alright. I have like 2 videos coming out soon. I'm still editing it, so you'll probably see that. You'll probably see that this week or even tomorrow. Alright. Bye, guys. Thanks for listening to me ramble.